Welcome back to Philippines Uncut. I'm Buddy Kunana. Tonight's topic is beautiful skin and wellness. Joining us still is Dr. Casey Reyes, the Medical Director of Lumini Skin and Laser Clinic. Dr. Yes. Casey, welcome back to our third and final segment. Yes. Now, interesting topic. We finished the second segment by talking about skincare, and you mentioned something about Caucasians and Asians, no? and how yeah. we age, how our skin has a way of changing the way we look as we age. Now, my question is, you know, a lot of people have noticed that Asians in general, we tend to have a longer shelf life. Like, we tend to age gracefully and we tend to age gracefully compared to our Caucasian counterparts. Why is it that, you know, Caucasians or people with white skin tend to look older, younger than Asians?
Because Asians, we have more melanin stored in our melanosomes. So it's a protection from the sun. And the number one cause of aging is sun exposure. Mm. So the Caucasian, they have less protection.
Melanin is the compound that makes us, that gives us our color.
Yes, yeah. At the same time, it protects us. It gives us color and it allows us to absorb more sun.
So the darker you are, the more protection you have against
yes,
the sun.
Yes. Okay. So if you compare us to, like, for example, for Nigerian, they have really good skin, right?
Oh yes, yes. 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 You know, it's true. Yeah. I mean, because they have a lot of melanin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And then.
And I guess also for Caucasians, let's say people from the West and the Northern Hemisphere.
Yeah.
Problema pa. A lot of them also love to sunbathe,
yes,
right, and exposure to sun because they want to have some color. They want to have some nice tan color or kind of reddish color. Now, what is the problem with exposing ourselves to the sun, Dr. Casey?
Yeah, especially with Caucasian, they're really they expose themselves to the sun. At the same time, the temperature there, it's very cold, so it allows evaporation of moisture from the skin cells, so it makes their skin more dry.
Yeah.
That's why they're more prone to wrinkling. Mm. And with sun exposure kasi, we have to protect ourselves, even if we're Filipinos, even if we're Asians, because it's the number one cause of aging. Mm. Yeah, if a patient is going to me and he or he wants a beauty product, and she has a and doctor, I just want one product. Don't give me too much. I just give sunblock.
Sunblock. Yeah. It's a simple yeah. thing. Yeah, sunblock. Yeah. Okay. Another nice question for you. You know, people who have all the sun, you know, sunblock, and they use sunblock. Yeah. There are a lot of products available, and this thing called SPF, no, sun protection factor.
Yes.
It's expensive, no?
Yes.
And sometimes I've seen SPF 100, mm-mm. SPF 150. I think I've even seen SPF 300 or something.
Yeah.
Like that. Tell us a bit about this SPF. What is SPF all about? How come do you have as low as 25 or 30 and as high as in the hundreds?
You know, even your makeup, even if you don't wear sunblock, your makeup, it gives you SPF 10. And what I recommend is at least SPF 30, because it gives 97% protection from the sun.
Okay.
If you try to use SPF 70 or SPF 100, it gives you 98% protection.
Wow.
So just 1% difference.
Because a lot of people think, okay, they have SPF 30. So if I use SPF 100, that's maybe 3 times protection. It's not true.
Not
it doesn't
true.
Follow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because what's important is the frequency. Because the half-life of all sunblock is 2 hours.
Regardless of SPF.
Regardless of SPF.
Okay. Okay.
So after 4 hours, it's all gone. So that's why you need to reapply after 4 hours.
Regardless of whether you go swimming or you just sit down it will regardless of what you do, the activity,
actually,
it will go away after, it will lose effectiveness after 2 hours.
4 hours. If you swim or
yeah.
if you sweat, like if you play golf, you sweat.
So faster.
There's no such thing as waterproof sunscreen or sunblock. There's only water resistant. If you sweat, you should apply every 80 minutes or every 40 minutes. It depends on your sunblock. It says there. They tell you if it's you should apply it after 80 minutes if you're going to swim
or play golf.
Yes.
Or,
actually,
know,
now in US, what yeah. they're going to do, they're going to just put the maximum SPF 50++. Actually, it's just a marketing strategy when people add like SPF 70, SPF 100.
Yeah.
But now they're going to regulate it in the States.
Why is that? How come, I mean, there's more regulation now with this whole SPF issue?
Because, you know, you really don't need to use a higher SPF. The importance is the frequency. It's more expensive if you buy the SPF 100.
And I mean, okay, coming from an alternative medicine point of view, these are chemicals, no? Like you're putting on your skin.
Yes.
And correct me if I'm wrong, doctor, I mean, whatever you put on your skin, the skin is a membrane, right?
Yeah.
Whatever you put on your skin can end up in your system.
Yes. What I do, I prefer physical sunblock, the ones containing the titanium or zinc oxide. It's really good. It's a really good physical sunblock that block all the UV rays. For the chemic, it's the most powerful. I give this sunblock to patient, especially patient with melasma problem.
Why do you call it physical sunblock?
Because it's not chemical. It's more of a. It's more. It provides more physical blockage.
Okay, so it's not a chemical block, but it's like a
physical,
like a layer.
Yes.
Putting like a layer of protection, like a physical layer of protection.
Exactly.
Okay, got it. Continue.
Exactly. So it's really good. What I do, I ask patient to apply sunblock 15 to 30 minutes before going under the sun, and then like when it's summer, when you go to the beach, you really have to reapply every time you sweat, like.
Which is a lot.
40 to 80 minutes.
Which is a lot. I mean, it's hot, right? You're in the beach, it's hot. You're going to sweat, right?
Yes.
Even if you're under an umbrella or something.
And then, and then I was saying earlier that you really need to apply more sunblock. Because according to studies, the people who have undergone, who've been the patient population in the studies, they apply more sunblock compared to the ordinary people.
Of course.
That's why it's really... You know,
even athletes, I see them maybe putting sunblock, golfers, right? And they're out for what, 5-6 hours at least, no?
Yeah.
And I see them putting once, and that's it. They don't reapply.
Yeah.
And what you're saying is that in a physical activity, especially golf, you're walking, you're swinging, you're sweating. You gotta reapply after 40 or 80
after
minutes.
40 minutes.
After 40 minutes,
40 to 80 minutes. It depends on the quality of the sunblock.
Now, if you don't reapply,
then you're exposed.
It's useless.
Yeah, you're exposed. You think you have protection already because you applied 2 hours or 3 hours ago. But since you sweat and there's no such thing as waterproof sunblock, you're already exposed to the sun. It's not like you don't have sunblock.
But Doc Casey, it's hard. I mean, for someone to actually keep in mind that every 40 minutes I have to apply shampoo. When you're playing golf, you forget, no? Or if you're at the beach, you put once and you think, you know, you're okay. But then you forget that you have to, you know, it takes a conscious effort.
That's why it's
really apply, no?
If you're an athlete, you have to incorporate in your lifestyle. It's a lifestyle modification if you want to protect yourself.
Okay, my golfer friend saying, "Oh, it's okay, Doc Casey. I put once, but then I have a beautiful umbrella girl with a big umbrella holding it, following me around, no? So how effective is this? Let's say people who walk around under the sun, they say, okay, I don't reapply too often, but I walk around with an umbrella, especially ladies. I see a lot of ladies walking around Makati like that. It's hot, and they have an umbrella.
But there's UVA rays that can pass through those umbrellas. Even your car, it can go into your car, even when you're driving. That's
really?
Why you really have to reapply. It can block the UVB rays, but the UVA rays, it can penetrate.
So what you're saying is, as a general life rule, you as a skin specialist and you know, dermatologist, you recommend to everyone watching that we put sunblock, regardless if we were out in the sun, regardless if we are in the beach, even our day-to-day lives. You said it goes through the car, it goes through umbrellas.
Yes, actually I do put sunblock on myself 2 to 3 times a day.
Wow.
It's really hard, but since it's my line and I know,
look at your skin, it's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
I mean, this is proof, no? This is proof.
Yes, thank you. That's why it's really hard. For me, sometimes I forget, but it's a lifestyle modification. You should incorporate really this method into your lifestyle, especially if you're an athlete.
You know, it's scary because I actually have a good friend who's a triathlete. He's a professional triathlete, and he's sponsored up by companies, and he never used sunblock.
Yeah,
and
how young is he?
He's 43.
Ah.
He's 43. And I've noticed that he really has an abundance of wrinkles already on his face.
Yeah.
I mean, he's fit as a horse, no?
Yes.
But his skin, wow. I mean, it's really...
But he's not dark, or is
he? He is kind of.
That's good for him.
Yeah.
At least he has more protection.
I mean, he's not dark, but like me, moreno.
Yeah. That's good. I mean, if he's whiter, like if he's an Australian, he might develop skin cancer already.
But
if that's the lifestyle that he's doing.
No, but still, even as Filipinos with sort of like moreno complexion, we still have to put sunblock. No, we still can get skin
because
cancer.
Because it's, you know, skin cancer is also abundant, like basal cell carcinoma, and squamous cell carcinoma, and even melanoma. But for like for Caucasians or for Australians, they have a preponderance with melanoma. That's why because they have less melanin.
Yes,
that's why they need to apply
sunblock.
At the same time, they go for a consult once a year or twice a year to check for the moles if it's cancer already.
Yeah.
But for us, we're not doing that because we're more protected. But it doesn't mean that we cannot develop melanoma or skin cancer anytime.
It can happen. Okay, quick tips. Now we have a few minutes to close. It's summertime now, and what are your tips? Quick tips to our audience on how to prevent, to care for the skin and protect them from this harsh environment, this harsh sun.
Yeah. So we've been talking about sunblock. You should wear your sunblock. And number two, when you go to the pool or when you go to community pools or community gyms, and if you sweat, try to use clean wipes or try to take a bath, because the moisture, this is the site for the fungi. Fungi and bacteria love to thrive in moisture environments. And we have normal bacteria and fungal elements on our skin. They're normal inhabitants. But during summer, it becomes there's an imbalance because the fungi or this bacteria, they thrive more to the area with moisture, especially sweat in the groin area and the axillary area, and then it can cause an infection. This is, for example, like for people who frequent the gyms, they can develop folliculitis, infection of the follicles, because the sweats and the dead skin cells and the
share machines, the, all that.
Yes, and the bacteria and the dirt, they get clogged in the follicles, that you can develop folliculitis. But for patients, especially the young kids who love swimming or sharing other...
Summertime, swimming lessons, it's a norm.
Sharing your bath towel with other kids, they might get fungal infection. They might, and if they walk on the pool area with no slippers, they might get the fungal elements. And if you don't wash it, and if you don't use antiseptic wash, you might develop fungal infection. This is very common now during summer.
And then you mentioned the best time to go to the sun, if you're going to the beach, 7 to 9 o'clock in the morning.
And then 2 p.m. to 6 p.m.
Because from 9 to 2 is when the sun is most damaging
time.
No?
Yes.
So 7 to 9 and then 2 to 6.
2 to 6.
2 to 6. Excellent. Now, let's talk about your clinic. Where can people reach you, Doc Casey?
You can visit us at Luminous Clinic. It's just above Mercury Drug Building, 32nd Street, 4th Avenue, in BGC, for Taguig, in Fort Bonifacio. So it's just across St. Luke's Hospital, Fort.
What about social media?
Social media.
Yeah.
You can visit us at www.luminous.com, or you can go to our Facebook page, it's Luminous, or you can visit our Instagram, it's Luminous_official. And then you can contact us at our landline number, it's 02-511-8500, and our cell number, it's 0917-521-5283.
You guys open 6 days a week? When are you guys?
7 days.
7 days a week,
yeah,
wow.
Every day.
And you're there every day?
Most of the time.
Wow, you work hard,
yeah,
huh? You're a hard worker, huh? but still youthful looking and good skin.
Yeah,
so you are the best brand endorser of Luminous Skin and Laser Clinic, Dr. Casey.
But it's really hard. It's really hard to modify your lifestyle. Sometimes I use my laser since I cannot say that I have the perfect lifestyle. So sometimes I use my lasers and other machines to improve something
of course, on my face. Of course, it has to be with our lives now. It's the modern world, a lot of stress, very fast paced.
Yes,
not so much time for take care of ourselves. Sometimes these things are needed, no?
Yes.
Excellent. Doc Casey, thank you for coming on the
show.
Thank
you so much.
No, thank you. And all the tips you gave us, very interesting. I learned a lot from you today. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And
I'll look
forward to visiting Luminous very soon.
Yes.
Thank you.
I'll see you.
So, guys, I hope you enjoyed our summer special on health, wellness, and beautiful skin here in Philippines Uncut. Join us again next week here in the show where we talk about matters to you guys, because you guys matter the most. I'll see you next week.
Thank you.
No, pleasure.